everybody. Jomo and the Possum Posse here with another installment of What Would Guy on a Buffalo Do? Hashtag WWGOABD. If you've got questions, you can type them in the comments below. I actually can't see them. We try to answer as many questions as we can, and we can't answer them all, but we'll try to answer the ones that aren't stupid. Just kidding, we like the stupid ones best, actually. I've got one here from RKCST on YouTube. He or she asked, what would Guy on a Buffalo do if he and the Buffalo joined a Uruguayan rugby team and they were on a flight to Chile and the plane crashed on a snowy mountain and they were all stranded there in the snow? And the other survivors were like, hey Guy, we're all getting really hungry, so I think we're going to eat your buffalo. And when the guy suggests that they eat dead people instead, they all said no, they want the buffalo, because it would be weird to eat people when there's a buffalo here. And great question. And I think that one's super obvious. We don't even have to get into that one. Vermont Bouldering on YouTube asks, what would Guy on a Buffalo do if he encountered a terrorist? And Daniel Swick, also on YouTube, asks, what if he itemized his taxes incorrectly? Great question, because it's tax season, so timely. And I happen to know two examples that are relevant to those questions. Two, three, four. Well, one day the guy on the buffalo got a letter from the IRS. They said it looks like you itemized some of your personal expenses as business expenses. And he said, in a nicely written letter, I think I have some rebuttals to that, but I'm gonna have to come down there and rebut in person, cause that's the guy on the buffalo. He said, hey IRS, here's a death certificate. I was actually on that golf course murdering a murderer. Street justice, which is well within my job description. And so the IRS gave him a big old refund, and then he went and got a new set of clubs with that money, and he also bought a really nice golf hat for his buffalo. And then the guy on the buffalo was on a plane trip over to Chile, unrelated to the other story, when a terrorist jumped up from the back row and he was like, you know, typical terrorist jargon, spouting off stuff. And the guy said, everybody cool it, everybody be calm. Terrorist, come over here. Let's sit down because there's an empty seat next to me. The guy on the buffalo said, hey terrorist, let's start an open dialogue. Let's start a discussion because I feel like a lot of times you're entrenched in your views and other people are entrenched in theirs. And then you're like, you know, villainizing them, they're villainizing you, and maybe, you know, social media might have a lot to do with it, because it's like an echo chamber, you know what I mean? Yeah. It's like people don't really talk to each other. And at the end of the day, don't we all just want to be happy?
I mean, if they're always trying to kill somebody, why don't they try loving somebody?
Yeah, exactly. And you know what? The guy on a buffalo then hired the terrorist, dropped all the charges. Turns out he was just a confused young man. Yeah. And now he manages the Twitter account for our band, the Possum Posse. You look us up. We do more than just Guy on a Buffalo.
Right.
More than just Guy on a Buffalo.